The Supreme Court had, in a unanimous decision of five justices held on January 29, that the Ejike Oguebego, executive of the PDP in Anambra State, was the only legitimate exco of the party. The court said the PDP constitution made no provision for the setting up of caretaker committees, and so the attempt by the national body of the party to set up one in 2013 was illegal. Following the judgment, Chris Uba and others who were the candidates that emerged from the primaries conducted by the Ejike Oguebego exco had written to INEC asking it to withdraw the certificates of return of Senator Andy Uba and others who were products of another exco. The controversy forced INEC to file an application to seek further clarification on the judgment. Justice John Okoro explained that the judgment by its ordinary meaning did not need to be subjected to any clarification, as Order 8, Rule 16 of the Supreme Court expressly stated that the court shall not review its judgment once given, except there is a clerical mistake. Justice Okoro said, "What was brought before the court was the issue of leadership of the PDP in Anambra State and not on the implication of the elections that was conducted thereafter." On the controversy on whether the certificate of return of Senator Uba and Oduor be withdrawn and fresh ones issued to the candidates of the Oguebego faction, the court said it never made such order. The court said that issue had been taken before the National Assembly Election Tribunal and Court of Appeal, which has the final say on such, and the court had established that the national leadership of the PDP submitted their names in compliance with the law. All counsel in the suit reacted to the decision of the court differently.
Those who are in the National Assembly now were nominees of the National Executive Committee of the PDP. So how can you now want to, from the back door, bring in people who are not nominated by the National Executive Committee?
We are happy because by so doing, the Supreme Court has maintained the dignity and integrity of the judiciary.
Wumi Obabori, AIT News, Abuja. The Supreme Court had, in a unanimous decision of five justices held on January 29, that the Ejike Oguebego, executive of the PDP in Anambra State, was the only legitimate exco of the party. The court said the PDP constitution made no provision for the setting up of caretaker committees, and so the attempt by the national body of the party to set up one in 2013 was illegal. Following the judgment, Chris Uba and others who were the candidates that emerged from the primaries conducted by the Ejike Oguebego exco had written to INEC asking it to withdraw the certificates of return of Senator Andy Uba and others who were products of another exco. The controversy forced INEC to file an application to seek further clarification on the judgment. Justice John Okoro explained that the judgment by its ordinary meaning did not need to be subjected to any clarification, as Order 8, Rule 16 of the Supreme Court expressly stated that the court shall not review its judgment once given, except there is a clerical mistake. Justice Okoro said, "What was brought before the court was the issue of leadership of the PDP in Anambra State and not on implication of the elections that was conducted thereafter." On the controversy on whether the certificate of return of Senator Uba and Oduor be withdrawn and fresh ones issued to the candidates of the Oguebego faction, the court said it never made such order. The court said that issue had been taken before the National Assembly Election Tribunal and Court of Appeal, which has the final say on such, and the court had established that the national leadership of the PDP submitted their names in compliance with the law. All counsel in the suit reacted to the decision of the court differently.
Those who are in the National Assembly now were nominees of the National Executive Committee of the PDP. So how can you now want to, from the back door, bring in people who are not nominated by the National Executive Committee?
We are happy because by so doing, the Supreme Court has maintained the dignity and integrity of the judiciary.
Wumi Obabori, AIT News, Abuja.